from the morning with a Greek coffee and a bougatsa maybe, which is a flaky pastry filled with sweet cream or savory cheese, to well into the evening with ouzo maybe, a glass of ouzo and calamari, Greece offers an outstanding range of delicious foods. But when it comes to choosing what to eat in Greece, staring at the menu in the restaurant and scratching your head, what should I eat? This year, we're looking for good quality Greek food, in-season meat, fish and vegetables, delicious nutritive dishes that meet not only the expectations of your taste buds, but tick the boxes on health and live up to the true Mediterranean diet origins of Greek food. Come with me as we explore the best 5 food choices in Greek restaurants. The Greek salad is the classic. Tomatoes, red, juicy, delicious, full of aroma and taste. Let's not forget olives, crumbly feta cheese, and crunchy cucumber. A classic fresh salad served all over Greece any season. Green leaf salad can have several variations as a secondary option. Grated cheese on the top and vinegar glaze, different greens according to the season. But all salads, in fact, the whole Greek cuisine are dressed in olive oil. Extra virgin olive oil, the highest quality possible, is the default choice on a Greek salad. And actually, the oil complements the flavor and adds freshness and pungency to the whole tasting experience. Just try it, you will see the difference between an extra virgin olive oil and a regular olive oil. Definitely recommend this type of oil in the salads, as all of its precious ingredients, vitamins and polyphenols, are not going to be affected because no heating is involved. Drop a comment if you would like to see a video on the benefits of olive oil in your diet. From oils in the salad to oils used in frying. Actually, I firmly believe that frying, if it's done right, it can be healthy. My recommendation in the fried category are fried courgettes, offered with a bit of tzatziki on the side, which is an excellent choice containing not so much oil, but containing lots of good minerals and vitamins. Appetizers. I mentioned already tzatziki, highly recommended, full-fat Greek yogurt, which is thick, strained yogurt, just in case you didn't know, with olive oil, smelly but very healthy garlic and diced cucumber. Aubergine salad is amazing. Barbecued aubergine stuffed with feta cheese and finished in the oven. There are many others, ranging from fresh pork sausages, feta cheese covered with sesame and honey. Wow, just imagine that, really, really tastes nice. Phyllo pies with spinach and feta and olive tapenade. It contains virgin olive oil and all its goodness, plus the olive itself, with all of the antioxidants that come with it. Spread it in a freshly made warm bread and take it to the next level. Here you have so many options, really. Moussaka, pastitsio, papuchaki, stuffed grape leaves, roasted lamb, just to name a few. And an entire category of casserole dishes, typically cooked with a lot, but a lot of olive oil, called lavera in Greek. All good, but remember the high oil intake. Just the fact that there is so much oil in your dish doesn't mean that you have to eat it, actually. You can just leave a bit of oil behind, right? Well, in this category, my recommendation is gemistá, which is stuffed pepper or tomatoes cooked in the oven. The stuffing usually doesn't contain mincemeat. It contains rice, but is juicy and full of herbs, pork and lamb, souvlaki, gyros. Grilled in Greece, these are the 2 types of meat that I would recommend in this category. These taste delicious, trust me. Gyros is pork, of course, meat. It's really nice as a street food, right? You wouldn't go to a restaurant looking for gyros because that's not something that maybe a local will do. If you're in the restaurant, you have so many other good choices, so why you would go for gyros? So if there is a souvla in the restaurant, souvla is also called on the spit or hog roaster, and you are into meat, then of course go for it. It's usually pork chops, kondo souvli, or young goat, which is katsikaki sti souvla. Both of these will be mouth-dropping tasty. Grilled chicken breast will be okay for the health conscious of you, but I don't expect to be blown away, honestly, from the flavor, just because, hey, let's face it, chicken, and especially breast chicken, is the dullest of the meats. It doesn't have a lot of flavor, does it? let's not forget the fresh fish. The smaller the fish, the better, especially if you don't know what to order. If you order a large fish, such as a sea bass or a sea bream, in a reasonable price, it is most likely to be a farmed fish and not an open sea, especially if you are not near a fishing village. For the wild fish, it is harder to find, a lot more expensive, and there is a lot to it. So my recommendation is stay away from the large fish and opt for sardines grilled, anchovies, which are fried usually, and smelt fish, aferina we call it. Medium-sized fish, like the red mullets, is also a solid option and guaranteed to be open sea if you find it offered in a Greek restaurant. I mean, the nice thing that desserts have in Greece, that they are complimentary. Yeah, you heard it right, complimentary desserts are part of your bill. They are free. But it depends on the restaurant and what they will offer you. It could be as small as a fruit bowl, for example, with slices of watermelon or melon, to something more elaborated, like ravani, halva, or baklava sweets. But they will come in moderate, small portions, which is not a bad thing, I mean. If you are really into desserts, most restaurants now offer the option to properly order a good portion of dessert. My recommendation for desserts is to actually try the local sweets according to the region of Greece that you happen to be. For example, in the islands, you usually find amygdalota, which is sugary almond paste, bite-sized sweets. What have we left out? Well, lots of other foods and drinks, beverages, and alcohol drinks, of course, like ouzo, wine, beer, and other things. A topic, I guess, for a future video. Sure enough, leave a comment if you like to see something like that. Subscribe, like the video if you haven't done it already by pressing the red button below. Check my playlist because we are continuing week by week providing you with the best possible content around this area of food science, nutrition, and ultimately health and well-being. Καλή όρεξη. Bon appetit. Bye-bye.